So Noam, it's been a year and or a year and a half. Well, maybe, I don't know, I think about a year and a half since we've worked together in this way. And though you've been sending me amazing treatments through the Skype that have been changing my life, especially the last one.
I'm very happy to hear it.
And there are some new things I know going on with you. You went to Brazil and you studied with a shaman. One or more than one?
The course was passed by two teachers,
Yes.
and it's in a place that one from of the teachers is Israeli, one and lives here, and the other one is also Israeli, but she lives there in Rio de Janeiro, and
Yes.
she's married to a local shaman that lives
Okay.
there. And this course has been taught in many countries and in many places. Also here in Israel, there are teachers that teach it. And for me, it was just an opening and things that I didn't believe that I can do. And I didn't believe that I will have the courage to do. Because for me, before that, I went to abroad 23 years ago. And since then, I didn't go. And it was for me to go to something which is like a school of, I don't remember the word in English, to pnimiya.
A dorm,
It's a school that you sleep
a
there.
dormitory school.
Yes. And I didn't know exactly what is going to be there and how the studies will be. And I knew it is going to be very
Intense.
strong and very intense. And I was a little afraid of it, but I felt that this is a gift for life. And this is exactly was the thing. And I thank God and I thank the teachers that were there, and also my friends that were other students for this adventure. It was a real adventure and it was fantastic.
All right. So,
I want to say something. It's not exactly that I have learned to be a shaman. Not yet.
all
For
right.
learning to be in a shaman takes many years and many studies.
And
It
many
was a very
lifetimes, right?
specific. It was a s something which was very specific from the curanderos of Mexico, and sometimes there were things from the Hopi also, and from the Mayan also, techniques that we have learned. But it was most of the things from the curanderos, and it was from a star, a woman that calls Star, which is very famous, and she taught many other things, and teachers that learned from her taught all this knowledge, and also teaching this knowledge around the world.
Curanderos, doesn't that mean like a seems to me Don Juan, the famous Carlos Castaneda uses the word. What does it mean
I
exactly?
don't know. My knowledge of this is very, very small. So
Okay,
I
that's
not
okay.
want to say
And nor
something
do I
which I
find
don't
it
know.
particularly important.
What I know is that the word curanderos comes from the word cura, which is cure,
Cure, that's
which
right.
is to heal.
The blanket staff.
And I know that it's from Mexican teachers, and it has many techniques that are wonderful. I told my friends that
The
for
second is
me,
on. Yes.
it was like to be in a Harry Potter school,
That the
because
second
it
panel
was
is on.
like to be in a magic. It was to do magic and to be in a magic, and there were a lot of times that I just looked at what we're doing and said to myself, wow, it's just exactly like in school of magicians, because it's so simple techniques with so much power that it was exactly like a magic to see it and
feel
it.
But since you've been back, you've seen amazing things. You just told me that you worked on a client who had a cyst, and on a particular part of her body, and you worked with her and the cyst disappeared.
Okay, first of all, I must say and remind that I'm only the messenger.
Yes, ma'am.
And when there is a messenger, the messenger, it's a duty is to bring what he accepts to the destination that he has to pass.
Yes.
And this is the reason that, for example, if there is a messenger that comes and brings me pizza, I won't hug him from love because in the pizza there is something which I love very much. And if the people forget to put in my pizza something that I like, I won't be angry of him because his part is only to take the pizza and to bring it from this place to that place. And this is exactly how I see myself. I see myself like a tube that accepts this energy, these messages, this kind of work, and pass it to the person that accepts it.
Yes, no.
But it's so important to understand that the most work is of the patient. It's of the person, because only if the person is really agreed to enter very deep inside to a very deep work, and not easy at all work, because when I'm working with person, it's not only energetic. Sometimes we just dove into to dive into very deep water of very hard feelings, very heavy feelings, and a lot of time there is such a sessions that people has to be in touch with their most hard feelings, and it's not so easy to do it. But from that point, of course, everything comes together, and it depends also on the person, which person is it, and the work is changing from one to another. But it's not only, okay, so I sit and I accept the energy and everything is fine. No, it's a very deep work. It's it's a very deep work on patterns, on feelings. It demands from the person dedication. It demands from the person to be honest with himself, first of all, and then from others. And therefore, I say that I'm only the tube. I'm only the messenger, because I pass the things, the techniques, the work. But if the person is not agreed to pass this path, nothing will happen. I can dance and I can do many things, but nothing will happen.
Yes, I'm sure that's so.
And therefore, once again said, it's not the messenger, it's the God that passes the things, and the person that is really agreed to accept the things and to take the devote to the process. And therefore, the process not all the time suits to everyone, because it demands a hard work.
For sure, no.
And yes, of course, what I can say, that this course that I was, it was, it just opened for me a new beautiful words, just new words, and it's I use it in my treatments, I use it, and I very enjoy, and I also explore it. I explore it with many different ways, with many for example beats and another rhythms, and I see that the difference happens by the energy, how does it come and how does it work. And sometimes when I add a specific word, sometimes all the energy changes by this. It's very changes from one person to another by the needs of this person to accept. Not all the time, it's what the person wants to get.
Yes.
But he accepts what he needs to get. And this is the most important thing.
Okay. I feel in our new work, since you've come back from Brazil, I feel a new power in the energy that you're sending into my body. It feels different and very, very clear. So, okay. So, but there's a lot of exciting things going on with you.
Mm-hmm.
You told me that lately you started getting regular messages from Yeshua, from Jesus.
Yes.
What
yes.
are those messages about? No, if you can tell us.
First of all, I want to say a few things about this. Jesus is a very beloved being, light being for me. And you, but even so, for me, also Jesus, also Buddha, also other beings are, signifies very important things that for them, I don't see them like signifies a kind of religious or
yes.
religion. I see them as a beings that signifies, for example, if I speak of Jesus, love and compassion. And to tell the truth, if I will say briefly, when I was a child, I was religious. And my home was religious.
Jewish religious.
Yes. And when I don't remember exactly in which year did it happen, I was very religious at that time. I don't remember if I was 20 or maybe 4, maybe more or less. Suddenly, I just saw Jesus in front of my eyes.
Oh my goodness. On the cross?
Yes, on the
oh
cross,
my.
Standing in front of me. And because every religious, I'm very sorry that it's like this in this world, every religious is sure that the truth is only in its hand, and the other religious hand are wrong and false, etc. This is the education that I got. This is the circumstances that I grow with.
Yes.
And suddenly, when I saw him appear in front of my eyes, I was scared. What's going on? And more than that, it continued something about a month, a whole month. All the time he stood in front of me, and I didn't understand what happened. I was sure that the Lucifer stole my soul.
Aye.
I just was, and I didn't know what to do. And I went to God and I asked his help and rabbis, etc. But I was so ashamed in myself. So I didn't go to a real rabbi because I knew that they will also me. But for example, to the Rebbe Milubavitch, that I didn't went to him physically, but
you would connect with him.
Yes, and many other things, and nothing happened, and nothing helped. After 1 month, it disappeared. But after that, came the dreams, and I had a dream which shook me very, very strong, and I still was religious there, that I saw that I have a very little boy with blue eyes and yellow hair, and I saw that Tzolvim Oto.
That they crucify him.
And it just shaked my soul. I didn't understand what does it mean, and I was very scared, but very afraid. But after that, there was a very, very long period that I didn't have any connection with him, except that when I started to channel, also he came to me and I channeled him. And from that point, I was not religious anymore, and I was much more open to see and to understand the beings and the real beings and the real signifies of every one of those beings. And at the last years of my life, I feel, and I know what is the connection between me and him. I feel Jesus very close to me. I feel him as my guide. He became to be one of my guidance, also personally and also, excuse me, mixed forgot the word.
Professionally.
And I feel very close to him. I love him very, very much. And after I came back from Brazil, I wanted, and the truth is that I wanted also last year, I wanted to go to Nazareth at the time of Christmas and to
Nazareth for all us English speakers.
Hmm?
Nazareth.
Ah, okay.
Nazareth, same Nazareth, like
yes,
we say.
Yes. And I just wanted to feel it and to see how does it look like and how does it feel when it's Christmas. And I went to a trip with a group of people, and when I arrived close to Nazareth, I just started to excite. I just felt excitement and I started to cry, and there was nothing that I could explain to other people that were there, why am I so exciting about the things. And since I had this trip, I felt Jesus very strong with me. After it, I went also at the 31 of December. I was first at the 24 and after
yes.
the 31. And then we also entered to a churches because the first trip was in the evening, so we couldn't enter. And since then, I just started to feel him very, very close with me. And since then, I started to channel him very intensively. And now it's not happens to me every day, but every week I just find myself sitting with my computer, channeling, sometimes go to do something else, and then once again comes and channels.
Yes, yes.
And about your question, the channels that I get from Jesus is speaking about this period. This period and the transformation that we are going to pass at the last few decades or even centuries that starts in this year. This year is an opening of a very intensive, strong and deep process that all of us, all the people that are in a wish to arrive to the next step in the evolution are passing right now. I believe that every one of us feels the intensive of life, that life became to be very intensive, and that there it's like an earthquake for every one of us, when even if it's personally, even if it's something which is more local or more global, but every one of us feels that the same thing that were normal for them at a few years ago, sometimes suddenly everything is shakes, everything is different.
Yeah.
Nothing is like it was even a month or a half of a year ago. And also the time changes. I know that even people that are not connected to the spirit feel that something happens with the time. The time changes its meaning. It's like that 1 hour that now we feel it was like 3 hours a half of a year ago, which means that it's like the time become more
compressed.
Yes,
yeah.
Much more essence, merukaz,
concentrated.
Yes, and it becomes to be more rapidly and more. It's something which everyone, even people that are not connected to anything that happens in this period, yes, no, feels it. And I think that it's something which is common also to spiritual people and also to non-spiritual people.
Yes.
Because everyone in its level, in its neighborhood, in its life, feels it's like a crisis. It's like a crisis.
A crisis.
A crisis. There are people that feels it more deeply and people that feels it less deeply, but it happens to all of us. And all the channels that I accept from Jesus, sometimes I look at them and I say to myself, oh my God, it just seems to be like even in Hebrew I forgot the word. Science fiction.
Science fiction.
It's like, it seems to be like a science fiction because he speaks about abilities that we will have, that we will discover in ourselves, in our bodies. He speaks about changing physical and biological changing and chemical changing of our bodies, also the physical bodies and also the all other bodies, about another functioning of the bodies, about things that seems to be, oh my God, it seems really, really strange. But I admit that I have a very deep lesson here, because the lesson is to leave the logical.
Leave it behind.
Leave it behind and say, okay, I give myself to what I accept and I just pass it. Logical, non-logical, seems to be like it was taken from a movie of science fiction. Everything is fine. I take it and I pass it. I don't have a background of physics. I don't have background of chemistry or biological. I don't know anything about it. Yes, all the time it interested me, but never I entered deeply to this, because all the
concepts, a musagim, a concept,
not the
formulas.
Forgot this word. I know this word, and forgot it. All those formulas, when I just heard it on sewing, don't know, I don't want to know, don't want to understand, just leave me alone. I want to dance, I want to sing, I want to read, I want to do many other things that I know to do, want to do, love to do. And suddenly, the things that I accept are speaking about our systems, about our organs, about our cells, about our DNA, and about also molecules and atoms and structures of that. And because I don't have any background, it scares.
It scares.
Because I don't know what am I writing about. I don't know.
Yes.
And this is a very deep lesson for me to release.
Yes.
To release and to give confidence, to trust that what I accept is what has to arrive.
Yes, I believe so.
And it's very interesting, but sometimes it seems to me like, okay, if people will see it, ambulance, and
straight
go, go to the Beit Meshugaim,
to the crazy house.
Yes. But if this is from one side, and my logical all the time said to me, what, but you do not know, and etc., etc. And I had a little crisis that at one time, that when they spoke with me about the DNA and about the molecular structure,
I
don't know anything of it. I said to myself, okay, I will leave it and I will go and look in the encyclopedia, in the Wikipedia about the DNA.
Yes.
And when I did it, it just broke me down, because I didn't see anything that is a... There was one thing that I saw that was very similar, but there were things that were much more processed, כאילו מתקדמים יותר.
Advanced.
That there was no connection or reminding of it in the science, in the real science.
In the Wikipedia.
And if it would happen to me even months before, I would leave everything. And I would say, okay, it's wrong what I am accepting. I won't continue in it. But at that time I decided, no, I leave the science aside and I give the things to comes to me, and I just trust.
Yes. You know, there was a great Indian scientist, a mathematician, and he wrote down formulas. He lived about 100 years ago. He grew up a poor boy, but he said that he was getting teaching and guidance and formulas from a goddess connected to mathematic knowledge. And so he received these calculus formulas. He's very famous. these calculus formulas, and it is the basis of today, 100 years later, of a lot of the most advanced mathematics. And Ancient Aliens, the wonderful program everybody on the History Channel, the most popular show on the History Channel, it's called Ancient Aliens,
mm-hmm.
with David Wilcock and wonderful teachers. And there was a show about genius, and they talked about this Indian man who lived 100 years ago. And even today, there are some of his formulas that they cannot understand. And
the truth is that at the last time they start to let me down formulas that I don't understand anything.
Yes.
I just understood that I have to write it. So I will write it.
Yes. His name, some complicated Hindu name for me,
mm-hmm.
Vimana, or I can't say the name, but if you do a YouTube search on Ancient Aliens and you look up genius, then they'll deal with this man. And Ramanuja, something like that. Anyway, I remember even a year and a half, 2 years ago or more, when you and I were doing healing work together. That means Noam was sending me healing. You would download formulas into me with specific sounds,
mm-hmm.
and I would feel the process energetically, even though I'm sure you didn't know what the formulas really meant, and certainly I didn't know what was in those formulas, but yet I felt the process energetically. I felt like I was being downloaded. And I want to say that my work with you, Noam, right now is so powerful,
mm-hmm.
and at such a wonderfully strong level. I haven't felt, you know, knock on wood, I see wood out there. I haven't felt quite this good for ever in this lifetime. And so, anyway, some very exciting things are going on with you. And aside from our healing work, which I'm so happy to be doing with you, maybe we might make more films.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe this will be a short film.
Mm-hmm.
And let me just ask if perhaps Jesus has a message or a blessing for us
today. First of all, briefly, I will just say what does it says in its tikshumin.
In the channelings.
Channeling. Sorry, my English just...
Today, by the way, your English is great. You're doing really good with the English.
It's not so good.
Yes,
okay.
It is.
Okay. First of all, thanks for all the compliments. I'm simple
from
person.
The heart. From
thanks.
The heart.
Okay. So he speaks first of all that now we are in a level that we are going in front of transform. And
transformation?
Not ma'avar. Transport.
To transport.
It's like we are coming to a T junction. And in this T junction, we can choose if we want to go this side or that side.
All right.
We can say that this junction is exactly the place that where the people that are allowed, that are prepared to pass to the next level of evolution will pass, and the others that are choosing not to pass will leave. We leave, it can be in many ways, but the specific way is that now there is a giant gamma energy that enters into Earth. It's about a month and a half even, almost. And this energy comes to us I can say very gently, because if it would come as it is, we were just dead, because we couldn't we couldn't stand in the force of it, in the strength of it. It comes to us in a few levels, and the level that it
today,
comes
by
now,
the way, today is January 30th. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The levels that it comes are coming to prepare us to the continuation. And one of its results is that a lot of people are sick in those days.
Yes.
The sickness that comes now at that period, it's not a real sickness. It comes because our bodies feel the new energy. And this energy, our body do not know how to cope with it. So because it doesn't know how to cope with it, it feels it like an attack. And because it feels it's like an attack, it makes a rejection, and it just rejects it and tries to defend itself. So this is the energy that comes now. But the energy that comes now is, we feel it at the smallest part of it, because it becomes more and more strong. And therefore, there will be people that will be able to stand in its force, and there will be people that won't be able to stand in it, and they will leave. So he speaks about few levels. The first level is before this T junction. It's the preparation that we are passing, that we will be able to arrive to this junction. After the transport, our bodies, and even through this transport and before it, our bodies are going to pass many changes, physical changes, biological changes, and it is going to be at the cell level, at the organs levels, at the systems levels, and also in the functions of our bodies and our organs and systems, and also in our abilities, that many things are going to be changed. He speaks generally about three levels: the levels that before the transform, the level of the transform, and the level that after the transform, that is itself going to be separated to few levels. So, therefore, the things that he speaks about, which are connected to the time that after this T, seems to be very, very strange and much more than we can understand. Okay, so
maybe he has a little message for us today.
Okay.
And a blessing.
Beloved ones, we are very happy to be here today and to transform for you the things. Because you have to understand, beloved ones, that not only words are coming through now, but also energy, also new formulas that are going to surround you. And if you will be able, and if you will allow, will also enter into you and give their present for you. Beloved ones, first of all, we would like you to understand that the things that have been told you now are not from a side of punishment. Please do not look on the things like good ones, bad ones, light, darkness, and punishment. Because this is not the way of God. This is not the look of God. The way of God is much higher than this explanation. this explanation is suits to human beings as you are, beloved ones, that your souls are still in your bodies, and therefore, because you still have lessons to learn, you look all the things through this screen that doesn't give you to see the whole picture, the divine picture that is in here. And therefore, we will give a very short introduction to explain the things. As a lot of you know, Earth was created and destroyed many times. And in every time that it happened, there was humanity that were here, a race that were here. There were many circles of Earth. And circle is from the point that Earth was built until the point it destroyed. Every one of those circles took another time. The time was depend in the development of the race that were, of the human race that were on this planet. And as you've been told in the past, after Earth was destroyed, when it created from the beginning, the zero point of this circle was the last point of the last circle, which means that when the second circle, for example, was created, it started at the end point of, at the point that Earth was destroyed at the last time.
Yes.
All the circles that you had until these times, as you were told by Kayon and by other beings, light beings, in every end of such a circle, Earth and all the humans and all the living that were on Earth were exploded. So the continuation of the evolution of the human race between one level to another one until now was by destroying, by death. That means that you had to leave your physical body in a purpose to enter to a new bodies in a new level, in a new circle, to start and to continue your evolution. This time, because you decided different, because our measure showed that the things were different, there was a new choose and new decision that were accepted. And by this decision, the circle that is going to end now, and you are in exactly in all of this itrachashut,
happening
that occurring right now, this circle is not going to end like the other circle. It's not going to end by the explosion of your planet. No, but it has to pass a very deep changes, a very strong and shaking changes, also for your planet and also for the humanity, to allow it to pass to the next step of the evolution. Because in this step of evolution, we do not demand anyone to leave its body, except it's the choice of its own soul. But for passing to the another step of the evolution, you need to be in a specific situation that can allow it. And therefore, the energies that comes to your planet are becoming more and more strong. This gamma energy that we speak about, it's a new gamma energy. It's not from the same source and the same way that you knew before. It comes, this energy comes and arrives from you from two main sources. The first one is the creation of the parallel Earth plant that occurring right now in a purpose to suit to you after the T junction. And the second one of the sources comes from another planets. Few of them are in your forgot the word, yekum,
universe,
and other from another universes. And this energy, therefore, creates, and not only creates, also carries dust stars from another very, very foreign stars for you. That this dust stars contains into it materials and formulas that are able and that are being no'adu.
That are built in order to
their purpose is to enter to your bodies, to enter to your creative bodies and life, and to start to give the push for the changing. More than that, as we told before, as we passed before, and this will be in another
program?
In another time.
Okay.
What is going to happen at the third level after the pass, after you will pass this T junction, is that your DNA is going to be changed. And one of the changes that are going to occur is that those pieces that comes from you, from another stars, will merge with the pieces in the DNA of you and will create a new DNA, which is will be built also from the pieces of you, your human race, and also from other races that right now are sending to you those materials, those energies, those formulas, those capsules, in a purpose to help you to start to observe and to create the potential of those changes that will occur maybe even in more few centuries ahead.
Oh, that's a long time.
Maybe.
All right, that's a very long time.
And why do we speak about centuries?
Okay.
It can also happen in decades. But, beloved ones, it depends. And you know with whom it depends, beloved ones.
Yes.
It depends in the human race decisions. It depends in your free will. Even as a person, and even as a groups, as a global human beings, as a global group, because the decision of the group, this is what will take the whole humanity forward, and this is what will decide in which rhythm will it happen. But it doesn't mean that because of this your personal progressive will stop. No, it won't be. It won't be that you will have to wait until the things will happen. You won't have to wait until all the group will change. First of all, most of the people that will pass to the other side, and we're not speaking about dying now, we're speaking now by the other side about the T-junction, about
yes.
the step to the new evolution. They will be prepared enough to that. They will be with much more consciousness, higher consciousness and wider consciousness that can also hold another people's consciousness. And therefore, this path will be for persons and for groups that will be prepared for that. And therefore, you're passing now the chaos that you see in your world. The chaos becomes more and more deeper, more and more stronger. And its purpose is to make the division, the divide,
yes.
between those who cannot pass this step to those that are able and will be able to do this pass. Now, we want you to understand once again, and therefore we are expand a little bit on this. the people that won't pass first of all because this is the choice and this is the agreement that they did with their souls before this period. As you know, your souls knew exactly to which period they are coming to. They knew that there will be a possibility of this process, and they knew that they will have a free choice if to pass or not to pass. But you have to understand that there were contracts.
Yes.
And a lot of the contracts of those souls were to arrive to this period and to live before the pass. So therefore you have to understand that those people that will pass, it's not because they're punished of something, it's because their souls chose to do this and to come back later, after that, in a way that they won't have to pass all the changes when they're on a bodies.
Yes.
They will come in another structure, in another period, but there will be others. Those others are the ones that won't be able, because they won't want to do it, to learn the lesson of the third dimension. And if they won't learn the lesson of the third dimension, they won't be able to pass to a higher dimension. And therefore, there is something which is not so easy that is going to be. Because for those souls, for those human beings, they won't come back to the fifth dimension, they will come back to the two dimension. Because they will have to pass from the beginning the lessons of the second dimension, in a purpose to arrive once again to the third dimension, and only if they will choose this time to learn the lesson of the third dimension and to release it, then they will be able to continue, but not at the time of the pass. There will be another chances in another periods for them, but only if they will decide to learn the lessons of the three dimension, and only if they will agree to understand that there are things above and beyond the third dimension, and to live the old way of the third dimension. Now, we spoke about the energy. This energy is so strong and going to be much stronger from time to time, that people that are vessels, that their tools are appropriate and can expand to another levels and will be prepared to contain this energy, to calculate it and to work with it, they will be prepared enough to arrive and to pass to the next step. But people that won't have the ability and won't have the will to do the work on what they have now, and the work to expand the ability of their nerve system and of their bodies, they just won't be able to carry this energy. They won't be able to contain this energy and to work, and therefore they will be burned by this energy. It doesn't mean that they will be on fire physically,
no.
But their nerve system won't be able to contain it, their cells, physical cells, their DNA won't be able to contain it, and therefore they will leave.
Okay.
I hope that this point is clear enough. Is it clear enough?
Well, the ones with spirit, so many people will leave, but the ones with spiritual understanding and inclination will be reborn in the fifth dimension. Is that correct?
No.
They will be reborn in the second dimension?
They won't be reborn. they won't have to die. The one that will pass to the another step, they won't, will...
I understand that.
They won't have to leave their bodies.
No, I understand that.
The body will have changes.
No, but I'm asking about the people who are going to leave. The ones who are
going
to die.
Okay.
Some of them will have to go to the second dimension and start from the beginning.
Yes.
But some of those
yes.
who will die
and
will be able to be reborn in the fifth dimension.
Or, it says once in...
More precisely, he says
yes, that it will be depend on their choice, because when they will die, their soul will come up, and when the soul will become up, they will have once again the ability to do their free choice, if they want to stay above or if they want to come back once again to the to the fifth dimension.
Sorry,
I'm speaking Hebrew, okay?
I will translate into English.
Okay. התעקשו לא ללמוד.
Those that insist on not learning.
ושלא לשנות שום דבר.
And not to change anything.
They won't have free choice.
Okay.
They will have to come back to the second dimension to start all over again, and then to arrive to the third dimension to learn their lessons, because when they do not learn the lessons of the third dimension, they cannot arrive to a higher dimension.
Yes, of course.
So this is the reason, so they won't have a free choice. But the other ones that will live, because it's their contract to live now.
Yes.
They will be the opportunity to come back at the fifth dimension. And now I want to speak a little bit about the contracts. There are closed contracts and open contracts. When there is a closed contract, it means that the soul anyway choose to die. Anyway choose that the person will die and she'll go up. In any case, open contracts, it means that even if the people, if the person is sick, but suddenly by its sickness he understands things, he learns things, he chooses differently, his soul, it means, not only
yes.
his personally willing,
yes.
but the willing of his soul, suddenly its soul changes its mind and wants not to die, but to learn the lesson and to continue in life, so she accepts it.
I understand. Got it. Okay.
Okay. If there is anything that is not clear enough, just ask, please.
Okay.
Beloved ones, you are in the middle of a whirlpool. Whirlpool that is a very storming whirlpool. Sometimes it seems to you that there is nothing that can be seen beyond those waves of this whirlpool. Sometimes it seems to be that the light and the darkness are fighting very, very strong. And now you are that into this whirlpool, sometimes wonder who will be the stronger one, who will be the one that will win in this struggling. But please, you have to understand that from the Most High God, this point of view is different, because what is happening now, it's like that you're entering all the things to a centrifuge, and this centrifuge starts to spin higher and higher and higher and rapidly, more and more and more and more, until there is a separation between the part that that stays in the center and the part that goes to the sides.
Yes.
And this is exactly the preparation for what is going to be in the T junction.
Yes.
So therefore you have to understand that your point of view that looks at things as bad or good is limited, because the things are going beyond your
perception. Understanding.
Mm-hmm. And therefore what you can see now is a little piece of the whole picture of what is happening now. You have to understand that your planet is not different from you, which means that your planet, the only different from you is that he's built it from a different chisut.
Density
of energy. And therefore you feel your planet different from you. But all the things that you pass, your planet pass at the same way. And as you will have this T-junction, also your planet will be in another level than it is now. Because also your planet has now all the changes that happens and that occurs now. Many of you see a lot of changes that happens, a lot of earthquake in a very strong levels that happens all over your planet. A very strong storms that comes, that becomes stronger and stronger, much more than it was in the years before. And many things becomes to be more kitsuni, radical.
Yes.
And this radically happens also in your countries, also in the things that happens between people, between nations, between groups of people. It's like that the radical becomes more and more deeper. The separation comes more and more deeper. But you have to understand, one of the things that sometimes seems to be even like a paradox, because in the way to arrive to unity, there must be a separation between what is suits to what doesn't suit anymore, between the new energy to the old energy. And only by this can the unity arrive, because there is no unity that can exist between the old energy and the new energy. The new energy has a new levels, has a new frequencies that the old energy cannot bear it and cannot contain it and cannot suit itself to it. And therefore it becomes a real difference between the two levels. It's like that in the beginning the things were like in one level, and then one level started to comes up. And when it started to comes up, the level that was before at the same automatically becomes lower than the new level. And more than this, because the higher level continues to go upper and upper and upper, the difference between the two levels becomes much more deeply and much more strongly. And there, as much as this distance become bigger, it's much harder to complete it. It's much harder to reach it.
Yes.
And because the old energy doesn't want to reach the level of the new energy, what is signifying the old energy is exactly the purpose of living at the same place, of staying at the same place. And more than this, it becomes to be much radical, the insistence to stay at the same level, at the same point, and even sometimes to react to the changes in war.
Yes.
And therefore, the distant between the two levels becomes more and more strongly.
Yes.
Therefore, there is no other choice. There must be the separation between the two levels in a purpose to get to the unity.
Yes.
Beloved one, you have to understand that we are here for you. All the time we are accompany you. We are here to assist you, to help you. And it depends in you to ask for this assistance, for this help. Assistance is Ezra or should they
help Ezra?
Okay. Sorry, I was a little confused
doing
between
good.
To
no.
insist
You're
and
doing
to assist.
Really good now.
Okay. And you have to understand that even if the thing seems to be very, very bad and very, very darkness, and even if it seems to be that the darkness comes and takes its place on the world, please be understand and remember that things are different in their purpose than it seems to be. Because in your eyes, it seems to be that the darkness wants to control and now accepted the opportunity to do this. But please understand that all the things has to happen in a purpose to make the difference. It's like that when people are looking for gold, when they're finding the gold and the gold is dirty with a lot of mud on it, first of all the people are cleaning the gold from the mud. And then you see the gold, but even this gold is not pure enough. So you take this gold and put it into a fire with a very, very, very high temperature.
Yes.
And this very high temperature, just it's like burn, but it's not exactly burning. What this fire makes, it makes a separation between the pure gold to the things that are accompanied to the gold, but it's not gold itself.
To the impurities. The impurities.
בעברית זה נקרא סיגים.
Okay.
סיגים של הזהב.
It
separates between the
dross
mm-hmm.
and the gold. Yes.
And the gold. And this is exactly what happens now in your humanity and in your planet also. Beloved ones, there are many changes that are going to occur also to your bodies, also to your planet, even right now. So please do not be afraid if suddenly there are a new disease that are mitgalot, that are
discovered.
Do not be afraid if suddenly you sick once again and again and again. Everything is fine. What you can do in this situation is to speak to your diva of your body, or if we will say it in a different way, to the representing being of your body, and say to her that everything is fine, that together we are going through it together, and we are learning how to suit ourselves together to the changes, and all the changes, it's okay, it's fine, it's not something that against us, it's something that comes to support us, and that we see this energy and we feel this energy and we learn how to accept this energy as a helper, as a tool for helping us to our changes that we need. And to say to this being that represents our body, and also we can do it, they say to me to explain it, we can do it also with our emotional body. It's very important, and with our inner child that is the most one that are the most afraid from all these changes. to say that this energy is not an enemy. This energy, it's a new thing that we still are not regular to, but we breathe it inside and we ask to understand how to calculate it, how to observe it, how to handle it. And we ask from this energy to enter into ourselves only the good things that we can use right now. And we can say to our representing being that not that it is not an enemy, but we do not have to defend ourselves in front of it. We can accept it, we can ask our nerve system to suit itself, to increase its ability to contain this energy, and just to ask that everything will be in a perfect way to our ability to contain and to our rhythm for histaglut.
Adaptation.
To this new situation. Beloved one, you are in a beautiful period, not an easy one, but this period is the most beautiful period that ever was since Earth is created.
Mm-hmm.
Because this beautiful period gives you the ability to reconnect all of your abilities, to reconnect to who you are much more than what you were in Lemuria and in Atlantis. Beloved ones, all of you know this sentence that say that the sky are the limit.
Yes.
But please understand that when you will discover all of your abilities with your new body that will be, and when you will discover all the playful things that you can do and all the strength that you have inside of you, you will understand that even the skies are not the limits, that there are no limits to what you can do and what you will be able to do. And I want to finish. Now it's me, it's Noam. First of all, I will ask Jesus if he wants to say something in addition. He said that everything is being done with a great love, even if it doesn't seem to be like this. With a lot of love and a lot of careness to all of human beings. We are always with you, beloved ones. Take care of yourself. And one more little thing. You have to understand that all the changes can start from one point. To agree to be humans. To accept yourself as humans. With the good things and the other things that you do not accept yet and you do not want so much, to learn how to accept it without judgment and to agree to change. We love you all from all of our hearts. I speak in my name. I love you all with all of my heart, and I accompany you in all of my love and compassion. You are blessed. With love. Jesus. Ani muda.
I
thank from all of my heart and from my love to Jesus for this knowledge and for this channeling. And I want to finish this conversation with something real. One of, I will try to say it very generally because I do not want to give things that may be identified to a person or something like this. But one of the people that I know, a woman, that doesn't have a specific organ in her body because they took it by operation.
Yeah.
When she went to a doctor and she said to a doctor that she believes that this organ can be built physically once again, the doctor, which is a regular doctor, looked into her eyes and said to her, "My dear, do you know that the scientist discovered that it's possible? Do you know that the science understood that many animals has this ability to grow once again organs that they were taken from them? Look at sea star. Look at lizard?
Lizard. Sister,
that when you take its tail, it grows it once again.
Yes.
Sister, when you take one of its hands, he grows it once again.
What's called a salamander can regrow a leg or...
And so this regular doctor, conventional doctor, told her that the scientists understood that also human beings has this ability. And she said to her, "My dear, you have to understand that everything is in our mind, which means that if we believe, we can, it can happen."
And there are case histories of real people, a little boy, nobody told him that he cannot regrow a leg, and he did. And I have a friend who regrew a spleen. They took out her spleen, Kisamara, not the gallbladder. She regrew her spleen. So
it is possible. And therefore we understand that all the limits are in our heads. So I thank you for being with us.
Yes.
And have a wonderful continuation of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, Noam. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.